Sisters, and it's Angela. Just wanted to come forth and show the outfit of today, this beautiful Friday afternoon. Planned an outing and decided I will go ahead and share what I'm wearing, just in case you are interested. I got this beautiful jumpsuit from Versona, and it was on sale. The original price of it is about $44, $45, something like that. Versona is a very affordable boutique that sells very unique pieces. Love that store. I got this for like $14, $15. I got it right away. I have mine in a small. It's a little big around the chest area, but that's okay because during the fall time, I wear it with a big maybe button down or Victorian type shirt to go with it with some boots. So it'll go good even in the fall time. This is a very breathable material. The legs are wide leg and very, like I said, very breathable piece of material. I like it a lot. That's why I decided to get it. I have so many black dresses and pieces I just couldn't pass up because it was so affordable. In a good material. Black is very good staple to have in the wardrobe. And you can wear it any season. And most people don't like to wear black during the hot season, but if it's a good breathable material, loose fitting, and you're gonna be inside, say with the mall or out to dinner, it's perfect. These shoes. Now, this may be the worst pair of sandals I've ever had, but I love the color so much I just decided to keep them. It's like it's made out of paper, but I love the color. I got them off of Amazon. I forget how much they were. They probably were no less than $30, something like that. But I got them because I wanted to wear green because of this beautiful beaded green bag that I got from Amazon as well. It's green, marbled, handles, just a beautiful, beautiful purse. And I don't really carry a lot of things in my purses, but I decided to get this one because it was very unique. I get so many compliments on it. Like I said, some things are better than Birkins. And I wasn't introduced to the Birkin world maybe about 3 years ago. I was in the room with a coworker. We were gonna plan to go out, and she had this beautiful purse. I was like, oh my God, that's a beautiful purse. It was like a vanilla colored with some silver hardware, gorgeous purse. And I said, where did you get that from, and how much was it? She said 20. I was like, oh, I could do that. That's a very good price. And she was like, no, 20,000. Well, several things went through my head at the time, but I never done such quick calculations, but in my head, I was like, that's 2 years of mortgage payment for me, so no judgment. She got it like that, that's just fine. So later on, I looked up prices of Birkins, and they were like between prices of $10,000 and $200,000. And I think nowadays we're hearing more and more, some of us, about Birkin Hermes. And I believe the creator of the Birkin bag passed away within the last 1 or 2 months. So rest in peace. I mean, now I don't know her personally, but I just happened to, when I was looking up the price of it again, I saw that she had passed away. But very beautiful bag, great quality material when I saw it, and very beautiful color. And now people are wearing it more and more. And, you know, there are some things, you know, that are better than Birkins. I love my purse. I wouldn't change it for anything. I think I paid probably less than $50 for it. Some things are priceless. If you can afford a Birkin, of course, do that. I wouldn't recommend or not recommend anyone to get one if you want one. But I don't feel bad that I don't have. And I don't think anyone else should either. But it's indeed a beautiful bag. but I'm not stressing about getting one. These glasses I got from Versona as well. They are with a green tint to them. I got this to cool down the outfit just a little bit. Most people don't associate this type of green with a summertime, so I just wanted to cool it off just a little bit and wear the green glasses. Minimalistic jewelry. I just want my skin to be skinning. No necklaces, and I have plenty of necklaces, but I decided I didn't want to wear any. This bracelet. I know some people might say that's a Van Cleef, but it is not. It's an inspiration of one, and it's very beautiful. I've had it for a while. I also had a necklace, but I was taking off a blouse one day and it broke. It's like a single clover with this jade necklace in it that I got from, not Ross, what's the other place? Forget. It was Ross, or what's the other place? I can't think of the name. I'll think of it later. But very affordable. I think I paid maybe $50 for it. And the Van Cleef itself, this type of bracelet, probably is about $13,000 if you look up the price of it, especially with the real jade color in it. Yeah, but you know, I'm not on that frequency right now. But when I got it, I didn't really even know anything about Van Cleef. A couple of years ago, I didn't know anything about Birkin. Sometimes when we're not on a particular level, or someone is not on our level, not saying better or less than, but even on Birkin's level, there are some things that are even more expensive than that, that those people probably don't even know about. Just like my purse, some people probably wouldn't even pay $50 or $30 for the type of purse I have. So it's just being appreciative of what you do have and knowing that there's much more that you can have if you want it. And if you don't want it, you can, you know, not even pay a lot of money for it at all. Anyway, I just wanted to come forth and just share the outfit of the day, just in case you're interested. I do have these fine gold hoop earrings to go with it. The perfume of the day is another Tom Ford. I'm in a Tom Ford mood lately, but just to be inspired, because Tom Ford fragrances, the 30 to 100 ml bottles are like between $200 and $400. I have done it, but I haven't done it lately. What I've done when I was getting them, I've got 1 month, and these are about from $50 to $80. I think this one was like $75. This is the Neroli. Let me look it up. This is the Neroli Portofino by Tom Ford. And I don't usually like Neroli. It's kind of vintage smelling to me. I don't really like Neroli, but it's something special about this fragrance, I think, especially for the summertime. It's just like opening a fresh fresh orange. Very fresh, like blood orange, as a matter of fact. But Tom Ford Portofino is a citrus aromatic fragrance for men and women. It was launched in 2011. The nose behind the fragrance is Rodrigo Flores Pute. Top notes are bergamot, mandarin orange, lemon, bitter orange, lavender, rosemary, myrtle. Middle notes are African orange flower, neroli, jasmine. Base notes are amber, angelica, and ambrette, musk, mallow. And this something very different about it is sort of citrus and animalic at the same time. So you just don't get the citrus vibe from this type of perfume, but it's kind of different. You pass by someone and it's like, you know, it's not just, oh, that's a very bright fragrance. More, it's very bright and very interesting and different. So that's why I like it, and that's why I chose to get that. So that's why I get the travel sizes, because like I said before, I'm not going to wear the same fragrances so much. And you don't really have to pay that much if you get the travel size. And like I said, I can have that maybe like for 6 months, different Tom Ford fragrances. And most of them now do come in travel size. So I have a lot of them that will last 1 or 2 years. Maybe I get one a month and have a Tom Ford collection. And if I want, you know, one that I like a lot that I'm going to wear more frequently, I maybe get a 30 or a 50 ml. So anyway, that's it for the outfit of the day. Wanted to come forth and share that. Hope that you have something interesting planned for you. I know I do. I'm going to get some dinner and enjoy the evening. Until next time, take care.